The other day, I was watching a telenovela, and it got me wondering, what is the fastest spoken language in the world? Well, according to a study published in 2019, there are at least two different answers to that question, depending on what you actually care about. Okay, let's get this out of the way right at the top. Obviously, individual people have different normal speaking rates. I mean, have you met Hank? I don't speak as fast as that guy on my most caffeinated days. And then there's the fact that different accents within the same language are spoken at different rates. Yeah, there's actually research that shows that on average, a US Southern accent is slower than Northern ones. So to find the fastest spoken language, you've got to recruit a bunch of people for at least as many languages as you can account for. In the study we're talking about here, the researchers targeted 17 languages, which is tiny compared to the total number of languages that exist in the world, but together they cover over 3 billion humans and 9 different language families. They even included Basque, which isn't related to any other language on the planet. Then they recruited native speakers of each language and had them read out translated versions of the same set of messages, and kept track of both how long it took them and how many syllables they spoke. Here is one of those example messages. Last night I opened the front door to let the cat out. It was such a beautiful evening that I wandered down the garden for a breath of fresh air. Then I heard a click as the door closed behind me. I realized I'd locked myself out. To cap it all, I was arrested while I was trying to force the door open. So how'd I score? Well, I don't know if that's good or bad. Okay, now let's cut to SciShow's own Hiroka Matsushima, who will read the same message but in Japanese.
昨夜、猫を外に出してやろうと玄関を開けたら、とても気持ちのいい夜だった。新鮮な空気を吸おうと、僕も外へ出てみると、背後でドアの閉まるカチッという音が聞こえ、締め出されてしまった。挙句の果てにドアをこじ開けようとしているところを逮捕されてしまった。
Now, this was just a demo of the experiment, and not of the results, because again, we're just two individuals providing one point of data for each language. But by doing this over and over with 170 different people, the team concluded that, on average, Spanish really is spoken faster than English. Spanish clocked in at 8 syllables per second compared to English's 6 syllables per second. In fact, Spanish had the study's second highest speed, beaten only by Japanese. But here's the thing. The goal of the study wasn't actually to work out which language is spoken the fastest. Instead, it was to find out which language has the highest information rate. And to find that, the researchers needed to work out how information dense each language is. In other words, how much information does each syllable convey? Again, on average. Take the Spanish word nerviosa. It means the same thing as nervous, but has twice as many syllables. So the information per syllable in nerviosa is half that of nervous. But Spanish can also say the same thing as English using fewer syllables. Instead of you're going too far, you can just say te pasas. So to rigorously compare the information density of all their languages, the research team turned to an old idea from the founder of the information age, Claude Shannon. In the 1940s, he invented what's now called the Shannon entropy, which measures the capacity something has to surprise you. Back in the 50s, he even tried to measure the value for English. And these days, it's used all over science and math. Like, a dice roll has more possible outcomes than a coin toss, so dice roll results are more surprising than coin tosses. And a dice roll's Shannon entropy is a larger number. The researchers behind our 2019 paper calculated both a language's Shannon entropy plus a slightly modified version called the second order Shannon entropy. And to get a value for that, you have to calculate how easy it is to guess the next syllable in a language. And as a side note, if that sounds kind of familiar, it might be because it's related to how large language models work. Once the team did a bunch of math using this fun-looking equation, they were able to produce an information density for each language. But again, they were looking at spoken languages, and speaking a language requires saying a bunch of syllables over time. So they also did some math to get the information rate. And yes, you can think of it as a bit rate, rate like when you're trying to transfer data on a computer. When we look at Spanish versus English, we find that both rates are roughly the same, around 43 bits per second. So on average, Spanish needs more syllables to convey the same information that English does. But since Spanish also gets syllables out quicker, ideas are conveyed in the same amount of time. But if you want to find out which language's bitrate came out on top, first you have to make it through this ad. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform that helps you build knowledge through interactive lessons. But with Brilliant, you don't have to sit down in a lecture hall at a specific time to learn. Instead, you can learn anywhere that your phone is, which is usually anywhere that you are. So if you're picking up your kid from soccer practice, waiting for your friend to meet you for brunch, or just whenever you have a spare minute, you can dive into a new topic or do a quick practice session. To try Brilliant for free, visit Brilliant.org/SciShow or scan the QR code on screen, or you can click the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. There are, of course, still some caveats to this study's findings. For one thing, the translations the participants read could never be 100% identical in terms of what information was conveyed. Like, French words for professions always convey gender, and Japanese honorifics denote relations in a way that English just can't. That context often gets lost in translation. So you can never say exactly how much information a syllable contains in one language compared to its direct translation in another. But despite the limitations, the team found a pattern across the 17 languages they investigated. Faster spoken languages tend to carry less information per syllable. That averaged out to the information rate across each language being roughly the same, 39 bits per second. If you are desperate to crown a winner, French had the highest average information rate at around 45 bits per second. Meanwhile, languages like German, Hungarian, and Thai would come in near the bottom of the proverbial leaderboard. But really, the headline coming out of this research is that no matter what language you speak, it seems you convey information at approximately the same rate, which kind of hints that something deeper is going on. The researchers speculated that it has something to do with how brains process information. There's probably a limit to how fast brains can consider information in spoken words, which means you can't speak quickly when the information content is too dense. But speaking too slowly or having too little information in each syllable isn't good either, because then a listener would have to store too much information in working memory for too long while you finish your point. This hypothesis seems to be backed by a new study published in the journal Neuron. Its authors looked beyond mere speaking, comparing bit rates calculated for a range of activities, from reading to typing to playing video games. They noted that our brains process information during these various activities at a rate between 5 and 50 bits per second, which is only a rough estimate, but the main takeaway was how narrow that range turned out to be. They also speculated that this rate could be deeply hardwired into how our neurons function, constraining everything we do, including speaking and listening. Whatever the answer, scientists are still working on it. That 2019 paper left a lot of major languages out, after all, and over the years, other papers have both supported and challenged its results. So if you're a French speaker, you might want to hold off before you purchase that fastest conveyor of information trophy.